scheduled 2.5 weeks at a couple of different field towns in Italy, and then as soon as the virus hit northern Italy, I canceled out and I realized, okay, that's what occurred to me. So I go there, I booked Airbnb places, cool places, you know, that are patios or, you know, these landscapes that I will love painting. But I thought, okay, so I get sick. No, there's no room service. Nobody's there to give me water or food or anything. I think this is a sort of a point in my life when that kind of freewheeling painting trips, you know, get a car, whatever. Oh, that's, you know, I'm finished with that. I really did it a lot, and I love doing that. But I've always absolutely loved my backyard, the field, and the woods around it. And I always knew I would really get into that as a subject. And I was sort of thinking, well, maybe when I'm 90 or something. Well, I'm almost 10 years early. anyway, I just knew that's what I was going to do. And I was also doing a lot of things around my place. One of them was having a gazebo built in the back, so actually face these, and there's this great big huge oak tree, so which is represented by that painting, and there's one on the wall there with kind of the bluish background that were painted in the gazebo on one of Mark's old easels. And so, you know, I just think, okay, I'm really into this. And then some of them were a little further afield where I schlepped my materials and set, you know, I wish I just sat down and paint, but, and now, of course, it's harder to get up and that sort of thing. But nonetheless, the feeling of just being there with some really, like the thistles, it's just like, it was just ethereal connected, because usually I don't go for like, okay, this little seed pod is flying off. You know, I mean, I'm usually not into observing to that, you know, that sort of precise detail and period in time. But it was really interesting. These little seed pods are flying off the thistles. And I just really picked up on a kind of a, when I see them, I really remember the wonderful feeling of being out there. You know, painting something, which I usually, when I paint landscape, I look for bigger shapes. You know, I usually don't focus in on some little detail with it. And now I think it's something I really love about, well, the piece, because usually I don't have details all over. You know, usually a lot of the painting is presenting this, and it's just kind of a major point of interest. But anyway, the feeling is that once I decided that, canceled my flight, and decided I'm now spending time, serious time with the nature and my property, is that a couple of words that come to mind that seem to be what my life's been about is one is stillness. You know, just a lot of stillness. And the other one is connecting to the divine, you know, just stillness, connecting to the divine. And the fact is that I do feel like hitting a certain stride, because you know what I'm doing, and you know I've had a lot of experience with ways of, you know, painting and that sort of thing. This is like, I really am not thinking. You know, I got in the studio and something suggested about what to work, which one to work on, what is it? I don't think as much about it. It's really, it just, and that I believe is as a breakthrough in a sense, because it's like, I think as artists, it's like you always have to depend a lot on you know, your inspiration and your intuitive. I mean, that's crucial in the arts. It's crucial, I think, in any creative activity that you are honoring your intuitive. But this is like, I'm kind of a Jesus freak. You know, I mean, I just really am into the divine. And I think we've neglected it too long. it's a huge power, it's a huge force, and of course, we know when we spend a lot of time in nature, we see, we're inspired, we have these feelings of getting beyond ourselves. And there are periods in time, like I'm now reading a Philokalia, which was written by desert monks back from the 3rd century to the 8th century. And people took this stuff really seriously. I mean, they wanted this wisdom. They wanted the purity. You know, I think that we are so, it's like this has nothing to do with politics. Nothing. Zero. You know, it's, but I'm very much thinking, this is my adventure, is being still. I know from my, I've read a lot of stuff, so I know I'm not good at fasting and all the things that the monks did, you know, to stay pure. I know that can't compare myself to their practices, but I can, there's certain things about it I can embrace. So it's stillness, and it's prayer, it's just openness, and it's watching yourself, because you have, with me, I find that if I watch myself, I see times when I make judgments about people. And that's, you know, that's sort of, that's not like, people might not think that's a serious sin, but it definitely is like the kind of karma that would block you from getting the pure divine energy. And so it's been that self-reformation in that sense, not in, just as it happens, as you're able to see what, you know, see the ways in which your mind has been formed on a lower stage, you know, and that you, you know, that your prayer is to, you know, to overturn old habits, you know, and really catch the breeze, you know. And I guess I've talked longer, but that's basically the mindset of me in this period of time. And so there's a lot of different works here. In fact, most of it's been in the past 2 years, but there are a few pieces, like this one of the Pantheon, which I started in 2016, and never quite resolved. I just got into the Pantheon, so I spent a lot of time thinking about how to compose the different elements so that it was a strong painting, you know, really a painting. So it took me, so that's one that I just grabbed. There's this one behind you was one from that I had done after a drawing trip. It was a tour of Scotland, but I chose to make it a drawing trip. And I had painted that in, and I just thought, well, I don't really like it. There's only two things I like about it, where I had started the little village, those architectural forms, and the figure that a friend, the person that was on the tour, took of me while I was drawing something on the site. And so I just painted everything else out, because I thought, this is not an interesting painting, I told myself. So I just thought, I'm just going to eliminate everything except what I like, and then see from there. And I really ended up loving the painting a great deal.
Was that Edinburgh?
No, it's not. We did go to Edinburgh, but this was just a drawing that I saw of, you know, a loose drawing. Memory's not my friend these days on some of the details. But anyway, something that I kept as because it was kind of a sketchy thing. It wasn't detailed, and I didn't want it to be a detailed specific place. I just wanted there to be that love of the Middle Ages, the towns, the steeples. You know, I wanted that sort of thing without it being a specific place. But I used the photograph. She's sitting on this rock, and so that was, you know, pretty literal. The painting, of course, even the first version, was painted all in the studio. It was on that trip. I only did drawings. I did not do watercolors or paintings. But anyway, Well, what I was going to say is that there are a few in the maybe there's four or five. I'm not sure how many that I actually had were paintings that I worked back into. The rest of them were all done in the last 2 years and influenced either by my field, or I had a couple of them, the Calipuya River, which is a river I really like, probably. Anyway, so they really are about this time staying at home, staying still, and just, just letting the greater energy inform me about what I'm going to do at any given moment, and then I rest in between. But it's a mindset that is about being at home and not being off somewhere that's, you know, some wonderful location that we go to travel. It's like, what's in my own backyard? Mm-hmm.